Hello, it has been a long time in this channel has no videos because our life is very much changing. But now we gonna start our journey in here in Finland. Actually it has started long time ago already. I have been now here more than 1 year, and my wife has been half a year now. And we was farming in Philippines little time, and my promise there in video and to her was that we try to do it here also, and here we are now. We have get the land about 3 months ago or so, and we have working hard. That is also the reason why we haven't so much time to make videos. Some videos in Finnish channel, it's called Yrttimäki, but it's in English it's like a herb hill. Is our name for this homestead, and almost everything is different. Just basic homesteading or keeping little farm is same, but of course climate rules and everything is very different here in Europe, especially in Finland. Here is all the things what you are doing is very monitoring here, and the regulations is so much, so you have to always think first you do doing things and fill the papers and get permissions. Our goal now is start this little farm here. We're focusing kind of we have, even we didn't know last time when we was in Philippines, we didn't know so much permaculture or things like that, what is best way. But actually we was doing kind of permaculture there the little time what we was start to planting things and using the picks for the turning the land and everything. It's pretty much permaculture or something like that. Too bad that we didn't have yet get picks here. Here is because the wild pigs, here is many rules about how you can keep even homestead level. If you want even couple, one or two pigs, you have to pick, you have to make a big fences, double fences with electricity, and it's not possible as yet. And one funny thing this country has, here is no more native pigs, only commercial pigs, and that is one of the things what we are really missing. If you have checking our videos in past, you can see that we have working lot of pigs, and it's amazing animals. We miss our pigs very much, but if possible next season we will take. And there is in Sweden has some heritage. Pigs, and if possible we have to start this coming winter processing that if we can get, and we starting here. I know now that Finland don't have like that some natives or heritage has, but it's not what I like. The Swedish heritage pigs are much same as what we have in Philippines. But that is later, we will tell you more about that when it's time. But what we have now, we will show. We try to keep this channel now like a vlogging little our everyday life, what is happening, what difficulties here is if you compare warm climate, homesteading and regulations and everything. But we have now, we have building little growing beds that we have vegetables. But we are focusing and our business planning this farm is that we growing herbs. Many kind of herbs, just the commercial herbs and wild herbs we are bringing here and seeding and one big difference is that here you have to put greenhouse. Like we have seen in this summer has been very cold. In May has frozen and we lost a lot of our tomatoes and everything, but they are good recovering. It's a long list what we have already, but I don't listing now here, but we will show. Especially I love, we have chilies, habaneros and beetroots and like that. And we try to keep this channel now at least once a week video and showing how is what else is just the growing the vegetables. We have chickens, Finnish native chicken in northern Finland. We like very much those. It's laying neck and one is sitting on the and there is a chicks maybe after 1 week. So lot of is happening now already here. And we are already staying here. As you can see, this is little cabin or just old container. Yes, you can say
what
container containers style. What has transforming little cabin and. We got this and we can introducing, but we gonna live off grid. We have little solar panel already here that we can operate, but when we have money, what?
Continue.
Yeah, when we have money, we buy bigger solar. And in winter time here is not much sun, so we need also little windmill what we can make electricity what we need. And we have to buy also here in camping a stove, wood stove, little one that we can warm up here. In Finland it can be minus 25 Celsius in winter time, so it can be very cold. But I think this is warm. We have to fix many things here still, and then but happily winter is not coming yet. We are now middle of the July or end of the July, and at least August should be quite warm still here before the fall and the winter. We need also wooden burning stove in sauna. We have little sauna here. And we go so much off-grid. We are all the time off-grid, but also we're following most ecological way of living what can. We make a dry toilet. We compost all our waste and we try to grow our food as much as possible. We have water source here and we need to make a well here. Also we have planning to take more animals, ducks. I hope the pigs next summer or next spring. Maybe sheep, we don't know yet how is. So lot of work and this land is little less than 1 hectare and we have rented also the little more and here is the space to get more land if possible. So we will see, we have to support working another place. And to get this all happens, we don't have income, only outcome for this farm. And well, my opinion is that it has done very well. What you are thinking, how this farm has going now?
Something 3 months ago, and we have a good vegetables plants going, and soon we can. And we have eating almost every day already the salad.
Yeah, salad and other things later.
And they are quite good and we will show everything how it is.
Have you learning anything?
So many things is new, but it's good.
Yeah, one of the nice things starting homestead like this is that it's like a school, life school. You are learning all the time. We both has working very different. We are not professional farmers or not educated any kind of agricultural or anything. Our knowledge is just from the books, from YouTube, and so many good permaculture and other channels. Also here Richtel is in Sweden and Swedish Homestead. We are following always those and but in Finland I think we are only one who is putting things in YouTube, but here is some good farms also.
And like also in library we get information in the book.
Yeah, the books. Yeah, library because no money to buy. Yeah, such a things. So many good things has happened, but also it's quite hard because our starting is 0. Actually it's minus. because we didn't get the land what is ready to farming. This is old farmland, actually very old. Here is the places where people has living something 200-300 years ago.
The same in Sikatuna also.
Yeah, but we don't know how is there. Yeah, kind of same, but you know, there is a lot of in Philippines we have a lot of forest also and like that, and we have here also, but so we have to like a pioneering to make a new land and start everything, and so many things what we can't make because of that. We don't have any compost, and even if you want to buy here is no. You can't buy here compost. It's not such a thing what people, they are making it, they need little they own, but big scale compost you can't buy. So we have to do everything our own. And one of main things what we have also, that almost everything we build is recycle. In online you can find that when people are giving something away, like a greenhouse here, if you want to build big greenhouse, is very expensive, something 4,000 euros, that is $5,500, and it's not even very big. But we have get free trampolines. Here is very popular. Almost every house has a kids has a trampoline where they are jumping, and when it's getting broken, it's very difficult to get rid of. But we are putting in Facebook and everywhere, we're checking if there is a someone has a broken. So we have taken, and now we have one greenhouse already. Functional, fully functional, and planning is to build 2 to 4 more. Hope this season we can get ready, that next season it's just the starting planting. But we are doing as much we can, but also we keeping this that I have seen so many farmers or homesteading like we are and you can see their face how tired they are and stress, and that is one thing what I don't want, that I don't like a just now this week Justin Rhodes, what we are following also there in US, he is putting also that need to change, because if you push yourself limits, then you get sick. Actually, I have been, now I am also a little sick. My kidneys has a problem and make me fever. But our profession is also that we can fix ourselves, joint therapy and like that. So now I feel much better. But that is also what now is important for us, that we don't push ourselves in limits. We are doing as much we can, and when it feels good. And we have really done a lot of this summer, and but so many things, so many plants, and we are also collect wild herbs. Wife has done most of that. Here is the berries and blueberries and
blueberries.
Many berries what you can find.
Blackberry.
Black currant. Yes, it's black currant. Yeah, and the cranberries and so many berries here, and mushrooms, what you can get. That is nice here, and but I don't want to make this first video so long, but this is now what we starting this channel again, and. We hope we can make interested videos, not only here in our farm, but I want to visit, hopefully here in Finland, and especially in Sweden. Hope we can meet those great guys what is doing farming, homesteading, permaculture, and what is happening, and our project. It's going slowly, but well. It's also, I don't know so many farms what is so north, like our channel now is, before it was farm in the Philippines, but now we are Nordic Permaculture, even we are not certificate permaculture designer or anything, but hope in future. But it's big challenge here. The season is 4 or 5 months, and you have to done everything after that is frozen and snowing and yeah. She knows already, she has been here winter, but that is big challenge because 6 months you can't go in your garden and you can't dig or but hope we don't have to dig so much. That is also principles what I want to follow, that no dig, no till. Of course you have to dig sometimes, at least not make a pond. That is one project also. So we try to keep this interested for you and hope we get a lot of new subscribers who are interested in permaculture and how different is in warmer climate. I miss that, but maybe someday if we can get everything we can also go back to Philippines at least winter times and start something there also, but for now we are here and enjoy here, working hard and we want to share that so many people has what we have make a Finnish videos and others they have a feeling that they learn and so we want to share what we are doing and this channel we are share maybe even more in our everyday struggling here. Yeah, thank you for watching and if you haven't subscribed please do and thumbs up and welcome. Bye.
Bye bye.